Hey, what's going on, guys? Brandon here with Texas Plinking with another long range video. This one's going to be kept pretty darn brief. Real quickly, just to talk about the gun first and foremost, this is kind of not necessarily a cohesive build that I had in mind. This is more so just a proving of components. So it's kind of just, it's an interesting one. One is going to be this upper Bear Creek Arsenal, BCA. You guys seen them before on the channel. They wanted to send me out a 223 24 inch upper. Pretty interesting proposition there if you want to do some precision long range shooting. 24 inch barrel out of a 223 Wild. Pretty cool. I don't know if you guys are being bothered by that wind. It is very windy out here, so we'll see how it plays. But 24 inch barrel, long barrel, fluted, straight flutes, really, really nice. It's going to give a lot of velocity to that 223. Speaking of the round itself, we're shooting some Hornady Black 75 grain Bowtell hollow point out of a 223 Wild barrel. Should be playing pretty nicely. Crap bipod, just a standard lower here, nothing crazy. I put on this stock just to give me a little bit more real estate on my cheek. Again, it's not a cohesive build. You would probably notice this optic though. So this is in fact a Vortex Razor HD Gen 2. This is a 4.5-27 with the brand new, on this model anyway, the new Tremor 3 reticle. Absolutely love it. I know it's weird seeing it on this build, but yeah, this is awaiting a different build. It's gonna be out in maybe a month or two. So I figured, why have the optic lying around doing nothing? Let's just throw it on this build. So I'm getting my impressions on this optic through this platform. But yeah, I mean, otherwise it wouldn't make a whole lot of sense to put a $3,400 scope on a rig that totaled up. Just the rifle is actually less than $500. Even though I like spending the coin on the optics, this one's a little weird. The street price on the scope anyway is more like $2,500. And for that, it's actually really great money. Still a bit much for this rig, but again, why not just prove it on here? I won't go into all the specs just yet on this scope. We'll save that for that video. But real quick, like I said, 4.5-27 is an awesome range. 56 millimeter bell, 34 millimeter main tube. The turrets are huge and tactile with locking features, zero stop, parallax, illumination, and the Tremor 3 reticle is just nuts. If you don't want the Tremor reticle, you could get another one with the EBR 7C or 2C. That's gonna be more like $2,000. Anyway, love it. We're gonna go ahead and show you guys a perspective using the Tacticam 5.0. Right now, let's just get the excuses out of the way. It's super windy and I'm shooting directly, as you can see from my squinting, into the sun. And it was actually kind of hard to see my target. I finally found it. 455 yards is our first target. Maybe if we have good luck with that one, we'll go stretch it to 686. But let's just try it out. I need to repaint those targets because it's just blending in with the background. But I just got one hit off camera, so that's good enough for me. Let's just see if we can rock and roll with it. First focal plane scope. Again, you guys kind of see that through the Tacticam viewpoint. But this Tremor 3, man, it's just got all kinds of compensation for windage, for bullet drop. It's nuts. Right now with the zero at 100 yards, we're at 2.1 mils. So it's actually flying out there pretty quickly for this 223 here. Let's see if we can't get going here. Like I said, that target is, it's easier to see the stand for it, but it's kind of hard to see the outline of that tombstone target. I'm just gonna go dead center here. It's pushing off to the right just a little bit. That wind down there is nuts. Gonna bring it up just about to 17 power. Ooh, those last two pushed a little to the right. I don't know if you guys could hear that wind, but it's knocking around at 75 grain 223 pretty darn well. I don't know if I'm gonna attempt the 686, but maybe just a couple times. We got five in here. Let's see if I could get all five, then we'll do it. Cool. That's a good way to end the 455. Tell you what, if I could manage to 5686 somewhere out there with this glare, we'll go ahead and try for it. But let's reposition real quick. All right, guys, not gonna lie, I feel like a broken record. I'm always complaining, but this time it's I don't know. Y'all make your own conclusion because you guys are gonna see through the same thing I am. But right towards the sun. The target's the same color as the background. It took me a while to find it. I found it, and it's windy as hell, so that'll be fun. I like these challenges, but whenever it's on camera and I'm trying to just prove a gun or whatever, that's when it can get a little frustrating. But I got that thing rolling, so check this out. Where I'm aiming right now is the steel target. Hopefully you guys recognize it. That's it. So you guys can see just how well that sucker blends in. And the tricky part here is gonna be zooming in enough to get a good impact, but not so much to where I can't trace my shot and see where I hit when I missed. Cause that's good. What's gonna make a quick follow-up shot. I'm at 5 mils and 1.3 for windage. Let's see. What a great start that is. Holy hell. I don't think I've ever made a first shot hit with a wind call in this high of winds. That I am very happy with. All right, let's see if we can keep that up. I'm thrilled with that. Ooh, just barely off to the right. All right, now I'll make a correction. Let's just do 0.2. Thank God I hit it and heard it, because I kind of, the gun jumped on me there. I couldn't see where it would have missed. That's a hit though. That was a couple in a row there. I might just have to call it. But yeah, guys, that's a Bear Creek Arsenal upper receiver. That's a 24-inch 223 wad with a 17-inch M-Lock handguard free float. I think this upper is like about 200, maybe a little more, maybe a little less, depending if they're running a sale, but it's a Bear Creek Arsenal, so it's not terribly expensive at all. And it shoots great. I did a quick grouping when I was sighting it in. It did a sub MOA, just under. It was like a 0.7 with this factory ammunition. Shooting pretty good out here with these conditions. Just a standard lower, no thrills. Again, guys, I don't know if this scope is applicable to this video, but I'm gonna talk about it anyway. Again, Razor HD Gen 2, 4.5 to 27 by 56, absolutely love it. It's a kind of a weird rig all put together, but it's actually shooting lights out. Rifle length gas system with a pretty heavy barrel overall, so the recoil impulse is super nice, super flat, and only about 60 shots through it so far, and not a single hiccup. But that'll do it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have a great day.